by, I guess, the foreigner, Mr. Lim Boon Heng, Minister of Prime Minister's Office, to please give his welcome address.
Signs of functional decline is through screening. Screening can bring to light early symptoms and interventions may then be offered. By maintaining or improving function, independence can be preserved and older adults can continue to perform their usual daily routines and daily activities. esteem. Now, following the launch of this clinical practice guidelines, the Health Promotion Board will be piloting the community functional screening program at selected wellness program sites, starting with Jurong Central, Jalan Besar, Gunung Baru, and Kreta Ayer Kim Seng. Over a 1 year period from September 2010, residents aged 60 years and above will be invited to participate in this pilot program. We have the functional status assessed at subsidized rates. Individuals who are experiencing functional decline will be counseled by nurses and referred to relevant healthcare services for follow-up consultation and appropriate treatment. The Wellness Program is a national program led by the People's Association, which aims to promote healthy living, physical activity, and social engagement among Singapore residents aged 50 years and above. A 2 year pilot of the Wellness Program was launched in 2008 in 12 constituencies. More than 17,000 seniors benefited from the program, exceeding our initial target of 12,000. With encouraging outcomes from the pilot phase, the wellness program has now been extended to another 30 sites. These wellness sites are located in the heart of each constituency and within the community to better reach out to their older residents. The wellness program is therefore the ideal platform to pilot the community functional screening program. And speaking as one who has been very much involved in this wellness program and how to implement it, it is always the follow-up that is the most important. We all know the benefits of physical activity. We know the benefits of Qigong and Tai Chi for balance. But to convince people to actually take it up is the difficult part. And I think that with this screening and with therefore the follow-up talks that we could have in our constituencies, I think by inviting people who are not screened to have problems to hear will probably help to motivate them to do the right thing so that they prevent themselves from getting to the stage where you have to take remedial measures. I think prevention is much better than remedy. And with this aging population, in fact, we are seeing different kinds of issues surface today. And Dr. Tan Jing Bok, my good friend, is here today. Otis was sitting down there. He's here, I suppose, as a GP, as a family doctor. But today, the kind of issues that come to us or present themselves at our meet the table sessions are changing. Professor Dean mentioned about dementia. I'm seeing cases of dementia appearing in people's sessions. At least I think that the science. I'm not trained, I'm not professional. But when a senior lady comes to me and requests for a rental flat of her own or a studio apartment, I have to ask questions. Well, who are you living with now? And it's a family. And then I say, what's the problem? You know, isn't it better you stay with the family? Then the signs of suspicion of the people who live with her, be it the daughter-in-law or somebody else, surfaces. So I think, I'm not sure, but I think suspicion of other people is also a sign of possible dementia. Or of complaints about new treatment because the family members don't give her anything to eat. Well, I know that we tend to have problems remembering what happened recently, but we can remember what happened 40 years ago. If we take what they tell us at face value, then probably we are looking for the wrong solutions. signs tell us, then we can actually provide a better service to people who come before us. And maybe help the family members to understand what may be happening. And then take the appropriate action. Now, I think the ECVG, this is just the start of one component of the many things we need to put in place so that we can cope actually with the aging population. A lot of people today don't understand what aging can bring, what kind of issues can bring to us, and a number of problems that we have is actually the result of lack of understanding. So as I said, this program that we are launching today is a useful component to our being able to provide service to the community more holistically. So this launch of the clinical practice guidelines on functional screening for older adults in the community is indeed timely. And with these guidelines, we will be able to introduce evidence-based functional screening in the community and promote the awareness of the importance of functional health in a growing population. Now, well, this is the HBP initiative program.